Posso avere un po' di attenzione da tutti? Anche dai bambini.
Even the children.
I was not a school teacher,
but I should have been.
Okay. This is a very brief presentation for Giuseppe Verdi. È una presentazione molto breve su Giuseppe Verdi. The Italians know who Giuseppe Verdi is. That's what I'll say. But we always have one way of looking at Giuseppe Verdi. Giuseppe Verdi, he composed the operas. That is a little more complex stuff. And especially for the children, what I would like to do is that I would like to get an interest about his special character in our Italian history. He's a special individual at all lasts. It's a very brief presentation. I'll try not to bore anybody. Viva Verdi is more tribute to a great man, composer, and Italian, with the emphasis on Italian. There would be Italy without him. What do you know about Giuseppe Verdi? What does modern Western society offer every day about him and his works? Plenty more than you would think. Commercials. With his most famous albums, such as La Donna Mobile, from Rigoletto, are invading the air on television. Movies and cartoons also have plenty of these albums. And I think I saw the other day a cartoon on TV, and they changed the words, but they said, that's Verdi, I couldn't believe it. Anyway, obviously he throws here because it's a rule. Okay, what about stamps from all over the world carrying this image? There's hundreds of them. I was looking on the internet and I found something like 252, I'm sure there is more.
Yes.
And from all the countries, even the United States. And there's coins and medals. Obviously the coins have to be from Italy. Because from another country, it's very hard to do a coin with somebody from another country. But they do have a lot of medals. And medals, well, those are only in Italian. They're the famous millionaire. Everybody remembers them, right? That I know of. Only in Italy you have that. He has patches of him all over the world. Now, if you look, the one on the right is in New York City. The one on the left is in the town where he was born. And the one in the middle is in Milan, where I come from. And it's right in front of the retirees' home, musicians, retired musicians' home, which he funded. We also have Verdi Square in Manhattan and Verdi streets all over the world. I counted about 2025. And let's not forget the theaters with his name. There's about 30 theaters Verdi in Italy. The one on the bottom here is the one in Giuseppe, is his own town, and it's a replica of the Scala of Milan. His operas even became comic books for kids. Comic books, they have comic books with his operas, La Traviata, Otello, Macbeth. He was a famous composer after all. Is that the only reason? No. Let's look into that. Giuseppe Fortunino Francesco Verdi. Italians are very, very generous with names. I got three names myself, so I know. Born Joseph Ferdinand François Verdi on October 10th, 1813, in a village near Busseto in Emilia Romagna, at the time part of the First French Empire. He was therefore born French, not Italian, because Napoleon, if you excuse me an expression, tried to take over Italy because he was Italian. He was refused admission by the Conservatory of Milan because he did not have enough talent. I think, yeah, stop it here for a moment. Yeah. He did not have enough talent. They didn't think he was talented enough. Now that's almost a joke, because now the Conservatory carries his name. It's Conservatorio Giuseppe Verdi. Next. In Busseto, Verdi met Antonio Baretti, a local merchant and a music lover who became his patron, finding some of his studies and helping throughout the dark years, and you'll hear about the dark years. He is the man that made Verdi possible, because Verdi was not rich and he couldn't have studied on his own. But thanks to him, he went to Milan, took private lessons, he then returned to his town and became the town music master. He also became music teacher for Peretti's daughter. And yeah, they fell in love. And so he married his daughter, Margherita Peretti, 1836. She gave him 2 children, but they both died as infants. Then in 1840, 1 year after the first death and 2 years after, 2 years after the first and 1 year after the second, she died of encephalitis. It was a common thing. It wasn't that hard. All you had to do is get measles, and sometimes you get encephalitis and you die. They didn't have antibiotics in those times. You see a trend? Tragedy in his life. Well, it gets worse. He was working in the second opera when the wife died. The opera was a flop, and he vowed to give up writing music. Thank God, the impresario Mascara had seen his first opera, he had funded the second one, and he asked him to write again. He convinced him. And that was a magic thing, because he wrote one of his best opera, Nabucco. A compelling story of the Jewish peoples. Look, I think we're going too fast, you gotta go. Compelling story of the Jewish people escaped from slavery. It was a success. So Nabucco was a very big success. At that time, he beat everybody in the opera. But why was it such a success? There was more to it. The choir of the Jewish slaves yearning for their land. Va pensiero sull'ali dorate. Fly, daughter, wings of gold. Go settle upon the slopes and the hills where soft and mild the sweet airs of our native land smells. Fragrant. Oh, my country, so beautiful and lost. That's the key fact. My country, Italy, is so beautiful, but it's lost. What did this word bring to the Italians? At the time, hope in the creation of a new nation, Italia. Viva Verdi was soon born. As you can see from, it's an acronym for Viva Vittorio Emanuele Red Italia. Viva Verdi. It was the true meaning people wanted to express when they said Viva Verdi. And you see from this drawing, these are people drawing from the times, people used to paint Viva Verdi on the walls. And they couldn't get arrested because it was not a political statement. But that's what he meant. I want Italy free from the Austro-Hungarian. Now everybody thought that he wrote Nabucco on purpose. We don't know for sure. But definitely Viva Pensiero was interesting. Next. What we know is that he wrote La Battaglia di Legnano specifically as an opera for purpose. That is, the Italian patriot family had an opera they could identify with. Anybody knows where Legnano is? Okay, I'll give you a break. My mother was born in Legnano. It's right next to Milano. It's 2 towns away from Milano, and there was a big battle. Why was it important? Because the Italians united against the Emperor Barbarossa, who wanted to squash Italy, not in Italy at that time. Hold this light. He wanted to squash out in Italy. So he got some of the Italian city states at that time to unite with him and go against most of the city states to unite. And they fought in Legnano, and for the first time in his life, he got such a beating that he never came back to Italy again. So that was the important symbology behind doing the Battaglia di Legnano, which, by the way, was the only opera that was not written in Italy. He wrote it in France because he was basically on a self-exile. Si era esiliato da solo per non vedere l'Italia caricata e calpestata dagli stranieri. He was named chamber of deputies, member, and then senator by the king as soon as the kingdom was formed. And Giuseppe Verdi wrote a total of 29 operas, and he is the most performed opera composer in the world as of today. Hold on to this one. What happens is that I happen to have, does anybody know what a blog is on the internet? It's like, you know what the internet is, right? Tu ti sanno cos'è internet? On the internet, there are pages that are created to inform people about a particular topic. I write about opera because I like opera. I started with Western opera. I used to like opera when I was a little kid. That was weird, you know? There's a lot of weird kids. I like opera. I like everything. stretch my blood, I noticed that for every opera there is out there by Verdi, there is another opera by any of the other composers. So he is played in opera houses of the world, sometimes 5-1, 6-1. So you can go now on the internet and you find La Traviata is played in 8 different theaters in the world, major theaters. Oman, Latvia, Lithuania, South America, United States. So it's all over because Verdi is that popular, because his songs can be sung in the street. La Pensiero is a typical example, right? But he did not write on the opera. He wrote the famous Requiem in honor of the great Italian writer Alessandro Manzoni. Actually, there's a little story about this. He didn't write it for Alessandro Manzoni originally. They asked him to write it for Rossini. Does anybody remember Rossini? Another opera writer that had died. And they asked him to do Mass. You know, it's beautiful music for the Mass, church, right? And he did. But somehow, the person that was supposed to organize the first event in church did not do well. It was his friend. Not after this, but he was his friend until then. He messed it up. So Verdi said, you know what? Forget it. I don't want you to play for Rossini. I love Rossini, but you messed it up. I don't want it to be played anymore. And he put it away. It was never played. So 3 years after, Alessandro Manzoni, who wrote Promessi Sposi, died, and he sat down to write another Mass, a Requiem Mass for him. But he realized that what he put in the drawer was a beautiful music. He didn't want it to get lost. So he got that, he added a little more, and he made this Requiem Mass for Manzoni. So this is called creative thinking. So if you look at one and the other, you listen to one and the other, they're almost identical because one is the child of the other. Now you also wrote 4 sacred works. Now you know what sacred works are, right? This is a religious association of some sort or not? Yes? Or no?
Yeah.
Let me respond. Un'associazione religiosa o no? Allora, ha scritto i 4 pezzi sacri. Ave Maria. Stavo Mater, l'Audio della Vergine Maria e il Te Deum. Stavo Mater è uno dei pezzi più famosi. It's one of the most famous pieces that you can hear. Now, if you have the opportunity, that's one thing you should do as a group. If they bring those 4 sacred pieces to New York, you should go to listen to that concert. It's a special concert. Now, for the people, since we talked about tragedy, go backwards. For the people that are worried about him because he lost his wife and he lost the kids, he actually lost his parents, all within like 4 years, he lost everybody. Now, there's one person to help him. His father-in-law. Now, is there any father-in-law here beside me? Ci sono I suoceri o no qui stasera? Ci sono I suoceri, ma no. Nessuno mi risponde, ma nobody's married here. Back on and says, you have to forget about my daughter that died, forget about your children, you have to write because you have a talent, you have a gift. And he convinced him, and I helped him in a lot of ways until he went back and started writing again. But anyway, a few years after his wife, I think 10 years after, he remarried with Giuseppina Speroni, who was a soprano, famous soprano. And he stayed until her death with her. And after that, he found company in another soprano, Teresa Stoltz. He definitely loved music, and the soprano were not those sopranos, okay? We got that, not those sopranos. Now, hold on, go back to the other one. You see that name? Ladies, you like gossip? Mi piacciono I pettegolezzi? Sì? Okay. Teresa Stoltz era la moglie del povero disgraziato che gli ha fatto l'affronto di non far suonare la messa Requiem di Alessandro Manzoni. It's a personal revenge. He did not appreciate his friend's behavior, and 2 months after his friend did not make him play the mass, his wife left him. strangely. So there was really something going on. She never officially moved in with him. Verdi was married at the time. He was married already 30 years, 30, 30 something years. And she was his first choice for soprano, and she was the one that played the first Aida. Everybody remembers Aida, right? In Egypt, with the elephants and everything. That was the first one. But this is the story. They say she was his daughter, but you know what? They have never found anything on her. In the old time, people used to write letters, and there was always some kind of documents that talked about, you know, your love for me. There was no internet, no telephone, so there was letters. There was nothing, but there was thoughts other than the fact that she was close to him. And she did spend the last years of his life with him, but not in the same house. She just was very, very, very close to him. As I said at the beginning, you know his work many ways. So you may be opera aficionado, and anybody loves opera here? Three, four. Click on the sound. No, yes. Why am I playing this? Sacra di quel periodo. Grazie.
aspetta